Well, this time of year, an awful lot of us end up, well, dealing with Christmas lights. And sometimes things don't go great. As a matter of fact, the lights I put on my house, I had like 4 bulbs that were out, and I panicked for a minute, but it worked out. And it sounds to me, Travis, like it totally depends on how the lights are made, the circuits. Tell me about this stuff.
Yeah, so there are a whole bunch of different types of holiday lights that you can buy. There's incandescent mini lights, there are new LED lights, and then there's a different style of LED lights that like to twinkle. And in order to figure out whether you can fix them at all and how to do that, you need to understand a little bit more about what's going on in the wiring.
Okay.
And so here at Echo, we have an encounter that we put out on the floor that visitors can come and do, and they're circuit blocks. So I've built 3 different types of circuits using the circuit blocks, and we're going to look at the differences between them. So we'll start with this circuit down here. This is a tricky little circuit. I'm going to hook it up, and we're going to light these lights up. And when we do, we see that the lights are all in a row, but the wiring is running in a big circle.
Yep.
Keep these in mind. They're sort of a false friend for us here. Then we move to a different style of light. This is a style you'll see in a lot of LED lights, especially the twinkle lights, where every single light is in a parallel circuit. So if we take this light out and put it back together, the lights stay lit.
Yep, okay.
These are, you know, a great one. You lose a bulb, they all keep working.
Nice.
And then finally, we get to this style over here. And this is a lot like an old incandescent mini light string, where all the lights are, again, in a long series together. And so when we run into a situation like this with our old incandescent lights, there's a cool trick I can show you to find which bulb might be bad.
Oh, okay.
So we're going to use a little tool here, a non-contact voltage detector. This is going to allow us to see where that break or that open is in the circuit. When you want to use one of these, the first thing to do is figure out which direction the lights are getting power. So there's nothing happening down at this end, but down at this end,
oh wow,
it starts to make some noise. And so now we need to figure out where in the string that stops. Oh, it's somewhere between these two.
Oh man, that is a cool tool.
Make sure we separate these out. Let's see. Ah, so now I know it's one of these two bulbs. I'm going to start with this one, see if replacing that one fixes the string.
Oh man.
And it does.
Man, that is way easier than going one after another, which I've done for years.
Yes. Now, when you go to do this, you want to make sure that you've got a string of incandescent mini lights. If you try to use the same thing on a newer set of LED lights, it's not going to work for you due to some differences in the way those strings are designed. And it's not going to work in a set like this either, which are lower voltage. They'll have a transformer in there somewhere. But luckily, this is the type of string you're most likely to have the problem with.
Okay, so do you have recommendations if somebody is hanging holiday lights?
Well, certainly we'd recommend that you go with the newer LEDs. A great thing about them is that when a bulb does fail, the string usually keeps working. But if you've got a string like this, you can try finding a non-contact voltage meter. There's a bunch of them out there, and seeing if you can fix them rather than throwing them out.
Excellent. Travis, thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Appreciate that. Hey, and good luck with your holiday lights.